Good morning, Lana, and welcome to our today's lesson on 3rd of August. We have begun a new month, and we can see how the months are moving with speed. We are now about 4 months away from the end of this year. So we began. You remember when Professor Magoha mentioned something about school, the president mentioned about school closure in March? And you have journeyed all along up until now, we are beginning August. So Lana, you remain strong and have faith that everything shall come to pass. I shall come again next year to begin Plazeta French. So as you can see, our today's lesson is going to be on word selection. And it comes to what we call word selection, Lana. This one cuts across. This one brings grammar. And make sure to have grammar at your fingertips to make you be able to answer simple, both simple and tough questions as far as grammar is concerned. So just to begin with, you can see number one, talking about the property was divided. What property here, if I can analyze it for now. Property, we can't add S to it, make state of properties. No. Even many things, when somebody has a lot of things, still her talk of her property. So even if the property are many, it remains like that. You don't pluralize to say properties. So the property was divided as 6 children. Lana, we talk of among or between. Bearing in mind that grammar says that among is used to show many things. Like, you are the brightest boy among your siblings. So siblings are many, your siblings are, you assume they are many at all. So we count you as the brightest or the prettiest among them. So for many, I'm on top of six. Six is more than two. So we talk of among two. Six are more than two. We talk of among, in that case, among the 6 children. And then the property was divided as 2 sons. We talk of two, Lana, we talk of between. So between now comes there. So how come, Lana, how come a man can't go there? The marking point I mentioned, when we talk about more than two, that is 3 and above, and talk of the mango was divided among the whole class, among my 54 candidates. And then, this pencil will be divided between position number 1 and position number 2. So this one were only 2 people that the pencil was going to be divided between. But talk of among, I want to give this box of biscuit to be divided among all class 8s. So Lana, I think you have marked that word very clearly. So after that, I'm going to give something before we go to number 2. There's something very crucial here I want to give before we can see the next thing. So these ones are our examples. I want to give something about, let me treat as number 2. Jane and Alice. Resulted dash. And then Roman 2 says, the pupils insulted Dash in class. So in our choices we have each other, then we have one another. Solana visit, leaving the questions again. Jane and Alice insulted Dash in class. And number two, we have the pupils insulted Dash in class. So do we say the pupils insulted each other in class? Or do we say the pupils insulted one another in class? Or Jane and Alice insulted each other in class? Or we say Jane and Alice insulted one another in class? Lana, give me the answer. If you are very keen, Lana, we need to look at the use of each other. Each other, meaning those people are two in the first place. That is the marking point. One another if we have more than. I've given this example immediately after the first one because they mean the same thing. They're not different in one way or the other. So we talk of Jane and Alice insulted each other. These are only two people. You can only see Jane and you can see Alice. Those are two. So we say Jane and Alice insulted each other in class. One was doing it for another, or one was doing it for the other. So they insulted each other, two people exchanging words. And then the second one is now the pupils insulted one another in class. Because there are many. One was doing it for another one gathered like that. So the pupils were insulting one another in class. But Jane and Alice, or James and Jane were insulted each other. Talk of a group of classes, for example. Class 7 insulted class 8. So the two classes insulted each other because we still talk of two groups of people. Two herds of cows fought each other. We still talk of each other there because those are groups of people, groups of animals. So Lana, what I want you to get is the number. Here, deal with the number. Don't deal with the way you can see it, taste sweet in the mouth, as far as grammar is concerned. Now, when you speak English, you can feel if it sounds well or bad. But here, don't look at the sound. Here, look at the number. The number gives you the answer automatically. So much for that. Lana, now go to the main example that we had written. So my brother, cannot make this one be example 3, let this one be 4, and let this one be 5, and then we call it a day. So example 3, my brother is dashed today than yesterday. In a month also he will be dashed. So we have well and better. You say my brother is dashed today. Today than yesterday. What do we say? My brother is better. Because of that, you can see the whatever is ahead of the sentence. Than is just used for comparison. So we are supposed to need to look at them. Talk of better. You remember whatever we have learned, let me have the example that we have done with. You might talk of positive. We have the comparison part. And then lastly, we have the superlative. From the word super, the superlative. So now you remember this very well. This is just measure like B. That's positive. Small. Pretty. B. Compare, you talk of bigger. You talk of smaller. We talk of prettier. Here we talk of biggest. Here we talk of smallest. And lastly, here we talk of prettiest. As far as consonants are concerned, now we say Jane is big. We have not compared, we have neither compared nor given superlative part. So we say, Jane is a big girl. Jane is now bigger than Tom. So we are comparing two things here. Even here, we have compared two days. My brother is dashed today than yesterday. So yesterday here, but then we talk of better. Because we are comparing. So now when we are comparing all the time, we use that little part. Jane is bigger. We are comparing two things.
So in this case, when even the examiner producer say that Jane is the dash girl among, no, between the twins, between the twins.
What do we say in this is a book recommendation? We say Jane is the prettier, because we are comparing only twins. Twins are two, so don't say it's the prettiest there. Let me look at the verb. The verb there is prettier. This we talk of degree of comparison.
So when we compare two things, learner, we use prettier. Don't say prettiest.
Prettiest will come when not compare Jane with many girls. That Jane is the prettiest girl in class 8, for example. So when you're talking about only two things, learner, remember all the time to say Jane is the prettier.
Mark is the bigger boy
between the two boys. Yes, but Mark is the biggest boy in class 5.
So lateral is done, well done, Nana. We take consideration into that. We take that into consideration. So my brother is better today than yesterday. We talk of that makes us to make it comparative. And then in a month or so, he will be better.
Better.
Then number four, he is ready to die that he was late. Then the man died not agree, not the man did not agree to die that he was guilty. So now if you look at this again, we have to work on confess and admit at the same time.
Those words I know are confusing you thoroughly.
So, when somebody confesses somebody, when somebody confess, to confess is the act of revealing, you reveal.
You know, when you have stolen somebody's car, meaning you know the truth very well with you. But when talking to court, the judge asks you, did you steal? And then you say, no, meaning you have not accepted, huh? You have not revealed the truth still. You're still holding a lie in you.
So we talk of now the man did not agree to confess. He didn't still reveal the truth. So he didn't agree to confess. The word confess now comes to confess. He didn't agree to confess. And the word admit is same as to agree, to admit. You agreed.
Did you admit that you stole the cow?
Yes, I admit.
Yes, I agree. So to agree is just to acknowledge, my name. To acknowledge. I acknowledge that I stole his property.
I agree. I want to acknowledge that this one happened.
Did you steal the cow? Yes, I stole the cow. Yes, I acknowledge that I did it.
And so here the answer now becomes admit. So to admit is simply to say yes,
to acknowledge, to agree,
and etc. So you can't say the man did not agree to confess, no? So to confess is the process of admitting now. The process of saying yes, I confess that indeed I did it. Don't just say I agree that I did, no. Now I think we are very clear there. That one thing, admit is to acknowledge, to say yes. And then to confess is simply to reveal the truth. To reveal, even if you didn't do it, but you reveal that you did not do it, that particular thing.
A number of cases in class happen. Somebody has stolen somebody's book, or somebody has picked somebody's pen, or somebody has misplaced his or her property. And people are asking class, who stole this property? Then one person is suspected to have stolen, have taken it. Then we take it to the staff room and ask you, did you steal? Then you start saying, no, I only saw it. While doing that, Lana, you have refused to confess whatever happened. You are just murmuring. You don't want to come out broadly to accept or refuse that you didn't take it. But in lack of admitting, we now say that, yes, teacher, I can say something about it. Meaning, you are admitting something. You are now saying, yes, you can now speak about it. But when you now come broadly and confess that you did it, it's you who took the pen, you now say that Ma has confessed that he has taken the pen. Ma has acknowledged, meaning you are, in that case, you have admitted that you did it. Then lastly, Lana, do I and not as I say? Do I and not as I say? So you say, do as I do. I'm not wrong, yes. Do as I do, and don't behave like. We don't behave like somebody, but you can't behave as somebody. We do as somebody does, but we behave. You know how behavior is now physical. We behave like somebody. You know, maybe right now the way you behave at home, you behave copying somebody, so you behave like somebody behaves. At times in class, you are told to act, to mimic or to imitate somebody. Like somebody told to imitate the way a hyena walks, for example. So you will mimic, you will imitate a hyena. So you will walk like a hyena does because you behave like that person. But when it comes to do, we do something as somebody does. We do something as somebody does, and we also not as somebody says. It comes to words, we do as somebody does, but we behave like somebody behaves. So then I want to stop there. These things are so many. We have the likes, if we add maybe two examples. You can talk of, I like the dash of Nairobi better than that of Mombasa. And the dash was done yesterday. That is weather and climate. So you can talk of, I like the dash of Nairobi better than the dash of Mombasa. Talk of the climate, not the weather there. I like the climate of Nairobi better than that of Mombasa. Then the weather was dull yesterday. Don't talk of that's a condition of hotness or coolness of a place. Talk of the weather was dull yesterday. Because the climate was dull yesterday. Climate is that for a long time, then the weather is for a specific day. So yesterday is a specific day and you talk of the weather. Then the artist turned his dash, who eagerly waited for his exhibition. Then we have the shopkeeper is very friendly with his dash. So well, we have the word customer and patron. Customer is for the shopkeeper. To whatever you can say, the shopkeeper is very friendly with his customers. Customers are tied to the shopkeeper, and then patrons. The word patron there. The artist thanked his patron who eagerly waited for his exhibition. So Lana, I want to stop there. Or I can add one more because of the condition it look confusing. This one here. Before driving, one should take in a day. Before driving, one should take a dash. A deep dash. And then the second one, the child was not able to dash dash due to code.
Due to code.
Pichelo zote mo dash.
Let's look at them. So what bread? What bread? And then we have the word breathe. So if you want to look at this word well, before you go to your dictionary, you need to know that this one is a noun, and then this one is a verb. Just like the word, then let me give this some few words here. Just like the word cloth, and the word cloth. Just like the word bath, and the word bath. This word, Lana, are going to help us learn today. Very important. This is the word cloth. Cloth here, Lana, is a verb. And this word here, cloth. The word cloth as well, this one is a noun. At times this one can also be a noun, and I'm going to explain how it can be a noun. And then Lana, this one is the word bath. Bath is a verb. And then bath, back here, is a noun. So a bath is just that place. Take a bath, take a bath. Take a bath, meaning we take that particular thing, is a noun that is taken. I'm going to take a bath. We talk of this. A bath, another bath. A bath is simply the, like a bathtub. You can also talk about the bath. I want the bath. So the word bath here is the act of going to bath. The act of doing it, the act. Meaning it's a verb in that case, the doing one. Then you're going to do, whatever you're going to do is, you're going to take a what? A bath. So bath here, different from bath. What is here, do not eat the noun. The noun, another noun here, the word cloth. Cloth is a long material, a large material that has to be made into a cloth. Like right now, what I'm putting on, I'm putting on a t-shirt here. The t-shirt is a good example of a cloth, of a cloth. But when you see big, a large material, like kitenge, kitenge has been bought that of a cloth. Then finally, the fooling will make it, will make it to be a cloth now that can be put on. The one that can be put on is now a cloth, still a noun, but it can also act as a verb. To cloth somebody. So to cloth somebody is to wear clothes for somebody. Or if you buy somebody a cloth, you can say, Father has clothed me, meaning he has bought for you what? A nice dress, for example. So much for that. This is just lead us to whatever we wanted to do here. We just mentioned about before driving, one should take in a deed. That, so talk of bread here. Bread. Bread is the noun. We should take in a noun. We should take in the bread. And then the child was not able to. The word to here meaning next is a what? It's a noun. It's a verb. To that, a doing one. To breathe. And then breathe now as an E at the end. So Lana, until next time, I'm going to stop there. I'm going to give you work that I expect you to do well. Bearing in mind that we have done enough today. So until next time, I want to wish you well. Learn and remain safe. And remain very optimistic that time shall come when we shall go back to class again and learn one-on-one. So I want to wish you a nice time as you remain safe at home.